Yes, good morning, Karen, and good morning to everybody watching you right now.
All right, let's have some good news, especially with the Christmas season coming up. I think lay it out exactly so tourists know what to do if they are planning to go to Boracay this Christmas.
As mentioned earlier, we started vaccinating our tourism workers last July. And as mentioned, those that are fully vaccinated are already at 91.2%. And then with the residents, it's at 62.9%. But those who've had the first dose, when we talk about tourism workers, it's already at 95%. Good. And with the residents, it's already at 84%. So we expect by the end of the month, 100% have been vaccinated, tourism workers plus residents. This is what we've been doing actually for the whole country. So last week when we met with the governor and Secretary Simato, Secretary Anyo, the governor already announced that since they're going to reach already 100%, they will accept fully vaccinated individuals in lieu of a negative RT-PCR. So that's good news for us. We've been asking already the governor to ease up on travel restrictions. And his only condition was, which was, okay, of course, valid, to vaccinate the tourism workers. And this is what we've been doing in the Department of Tourism.
Okay. So a clarification. If you are coming from Manila, for example, and you want to go to Boracay, is a vaccination first a requirement? As a tourist?
Well, as of now, according to the governor, in a month's time, he will finally, it's always best first to check with the LGU.
Okay.
Well, if right now, you're going right now, it's still a negative RT-PCR.
Okay.
But if, for example, according to him, in a month's time or maybe in 3 weeks' time, he will already be accepting fully vaccinated in lieu of negative RT-PCR. But of course, Karen, if you're not vaccinated, you still have to give a negative RT-PCR. This only goes for fully vaccinated individuals. Now, people are asking me, what are fully vaccinated? Fully vaccinated is 2 weeks after the second dose.
Okay, so let's say this Christmas, if you're fully vaccinated first as an individual, two doses, you still need a negative RT-PCR.
No more now. For Christmas, okay. December, all you have to show is that you are fully vaccinated. And when we discuss this with the local government, with the governor, you just have to show the vaccert PH.
Okay.
Because that's one of the many ways that he can authenticate, the LGU can authenticate that the person is really fully vaccinated.
Okay, but Secretary Puyat, do airlines know this too? Baka naman
yes,
hindi
kapasayan
ng eroplano.
Alam na. In fact, they were the first, nakakatawa, when we were just having our meeting last Friday, they were already texting me because they were so excited. Because syempre, hopefully that all other tourist destinations follow.
Okay.
It's not only Boracay. Baguio already accepts fully vaccinated.
Without
RT-PCR, Iloilo City, Negros Occidental. So slowly, a lot of the LGUs are already accepting fully vaccinated in lieu of negative RT-PCR.
Okay. Now, age groups. So you have families planning Christmas.
Yeah.
Pwede ba magdala Secretary ng Sanggol? Their toddler, two-year-old. Paano yun?
Okay. That's what we already, you know, Karen, we've been fighting for no age restrictions since last year. Last year already, pinayagan na ng IATF, no age restrictions. But of course, it really still depends also on the LGU. Kasi sometimes, IATF already says no more age restrictions, but biglang the LGU is not comfortable in accepting below 18. Mm-hmm. So, twice na yan, last year and this June. So now again, pwede na from Metro Manila, no age restrictions, provided that the LGU agrees. But Boracay, of course, agrees, no age restrictions, kasama ang Sanggol.
Oo. Okay. At ang mga bata na, of course, vaccination is now open for minors. Kung hindi pa vaccinated ang bata,
negative RT-PCR. Negative RT-PCR. So okay. It you'll just make it a general rule. Pag hindi ka bakunado, then negative RT-PCR. But if you're fully vaccinated, no need.
Okay. Next question, how many hotels are you allowing to operate in Boracay, and what is the capacity that you are allowing for Christmas?
Yun na nga, that was asked nga. The normal, even pre-pandemic, most of the hotels already were DOT accredited. As long as it's DOT accredited, it's allowed. I don't have the numbers of how many hotels are accredited, but it won't be a problem because we've been already accrediting since last year. So anybody that applies, mabilis naman yung DOT accreditation, can open. So that's actually not a problem.
Oo. Okay, a question coming in here, Secretary. Can you clarify this? Because a provincial executive, itong si Aklan Provincial Health Officer, Dr. Quachon, says that if you are a non-local tourist of Boracay, you're still required to show an RT-PCR test even if you are fully vaccinated. So
right
this
now,
might cause some confusion.
Yeah, yeah. Because what the governor announced last Friday, in a month's time, when okay. everybody... But Boracay already has all their vaccines, so they're just already vaccinating the tourism workers plus the residents. So the governor announced last Friday, in a month's time, they will be accepting.
Oo. So which means Christmas...
Right now. Christmas, pasok na pasok na.
Oo, pasok na pasok na.
Fully vaccinated. In fact nga, as of October 26, ang naka-first dose na, include tourism workers plus resident, 84% already.
Okay.
Kayang-kaya na yan. You know, Karen, we've already also given the vaccines for 12 to 17. So, we're expecting even Christmas, tataas pa ito. Kasi the eligible population we are talking about is the ones all above 18. Pero may 5,000 daw na between 12 to 17. We've already delivered the vaccines for them. So by Christmas, yun. You know, can I just, that we're so happy with Boracay. The reason why, and would you believe there are no active cases now?
Yeah, that's good news.
Vaccination really works. Walang vaccination hesitancy talaga sa, lalo na sa tourism workers. Everybody wanted to be vaccinated. So the last active case was last week. One only, mild pa.
Okay.
So vaccinations work. Yeah, that's why we're hoping to do this for the whole country, all the tourism destinations.
Okay. Now, in terms of the number of tourists in Boracay, how many are you allowing? Of course, after Boracay was rehabilitated under this administration, there was a change on the allowable number of people on the island itself.
Oh, pre-pandemic, of course, the carrying capacity was 19,000 at any given day. But with the pandemic, nakakatama lang ng 700 per day. So it's really within the carrying capacity. So pre-pandemic, they were, I think, accepting within the carrying capacity, 16,000 at any given day. Ngayon, with the pandemic, it's only 700. So definitely, everybody that wants to enter Boracay will be able to enter. Kasi even naman pre-pandemic, it is within the carrying capacity.
So you're saying, Secretary, this Christmas, you're allowing 16,000 people in Boracay?
Well, before it was 19,000 at any given time. You know, with the hotels naman, it's 100% naman and there is no limit. All we really just ask is
100%.
Even during pandemic, yeah, we allow 100% occupancy rate. But yun na nga, it's still always we remind everybody, kahit na fully vaccinated or may negative RT-PCR, to still follow the minimum health and safety protocols. Kasi baka naman people will think na, nako, pwede nang fully vaccinated, negative RT-PCR, ganon. And then they'll still party, they'll do pre-pandemic. Yeah. Hindi naman.
So what are you allowing, Secretary, in Boracay, especially Christmas and New Year? Are you allowing parties to be thrown?
We still have to work with that. It's really the LGU. Hindi na siguro like yung pre-pandemic talaga na yung parties. Hindi na pwede. Lalo na kasi there's still a pandemic. We still encourage, of course, wear a mask when it makes sense. Diba? So, still wear a mask when you can. Physical distancing with people you don't know. Karen, kasi lalo na you know so many people. Kung hindi mo naman kilala, not within your bubble, stick within your bubble pa rin. And always wash your hands.